every class you take ideally is like, how can I understand God better, love him better, and then share this with the people of God? On top of all like the practical stuff of like, how do you baptize a baby? I'm Brother Leo Dornan. I'm here at my seminary, Mount St. Mary's Seminary in Emmitsburg, Maryland, in our Immaculate Conception Chapel. So right now I'm what's called second theology, so this is only my second year here. Still got two more to go after this, but so far so good. The ultimate goal is to become a priest. I guess the next big milestone is deacon in 2 years. Seminary can be quite a lot of fun. Basically, if you're not in class or praying, there's a good chance you're playing some sort of sport. Guys go for hikes, they go fishing, they go, I don't know, read a book in the library. I'm part of the Pittsburgh Oratory of St. Philip Neri, which is technically, it's not an order. We're just a community of secular priests. With the oratory, so it was founded by St. Philip Neri in like the 16th century. And oftentimes for oratorians, it starts with a devotion or a growing love of St. Philip. And that's how, that was part of the reason. Like in high school, I started asking St. Philip for intercession without really knowing he had anything to do with the oratory. And then in college, once I started discerning the priesthood more seriously, turns out St. Philip was there with the oratory, which really checked all the boxes of what I felt like I was looking for. Your vocation is what God has put you on this earth to do. It's what he's given you to do that he hasn't given to anyone else. It's your job, your vocation is your task from God. Of course, there's the married life, which most people are familiar with. And then there's the priesthood, but that can take many forms. It could be diocesan, or it could be a monastic order, or something entirely different, like what the oratory is. You could also, maybe you're not called to the priesthood, maybe you just wanna be a religious brother or a religious sister. So there's a lot of options out there. So everyone's discerning a vocation. I mean, so I think you need to take that seriously of just, you gotta be committed to talking to God about it, just taking it to prayer, and also taking it seriously as like just making a prudential decision. You've got, what is God calling me to do? What are my gifts? What has he given me in my life? And just looking at, well, what makes sense? And asking God, is this what you've set up for me? Is this what it's all been leading up to? So during Vocations Awareness Week, one of the things I think that's huge is just praying for the seminarians or for the religious novices and postulants that are going through formation in your diocese or that you know. I mean, we all need prayers. And also just praying for yourself or anyone else in your life who's not quite sure what they're called to yet. And just asking God to like make sure that you're open to whatever he's calling you. And just really a spirit of openness and spirit of docility to maybe God's calling me to this. But that's a hard thing and something that needs to be asked for in prayer.